energy audit is an assessment of your home's energy efficiency, so you can save money in the long run and create a plan that targets the areas you need to fix. When done by a professional, this procedure usually costs $300 to $500. So instead, we put together this guide so you can tackle this procedure yourself. The first spot to check on the home energy audit is to review the entire home for any air leaks. This sounds daunting, but you can start inside by inspecting around the doors and the windows, which is generally the biggest reasons behind air leaks. It's also really important to check other places in your home like the baseboards, the juncture of walls and ceilings, light fixtures, and electrical outlets. Here's a quick trick. If you're looking for small leaks around your home, begin by closing all your home's doors and windows and turn off any appliances that are combustible, such as your furnace and water heater. Next, turn on the exhaust fans in the kitchen and bathrooms. Light an incense and slowly move it around the doors and windows to see if any of the smoke gets sucked or blown away or remains steady. If you see any movement, it's usually being caused by a leak. Now, once leaks are identified, caulking and weather stripping may become your new best friend. And when reviewing the exterior of the home, look for leaks in places where two different building materials meet and inspect the spots where cables and pipes enter your home as well. It's also really important to check your fireplace damper and to ensure that it's closed so there's no cold air leaking into your home. If walls and floors are cold to the touch in winter, or if there's uneven heating levels within the home, you may need to improve the insulation. Your attic is also an important place to check for proper insulation. If you can see the top of the joists in the attic, you'll need additional insulation. And to check your walls, you'll need the help of an infrared thermometer or a thermal imaging camera that will help identify the hot and cold spots. Check your furnace or water heater. If they aren't working properly, your energy bill is going to suffer. And if you used a forced air heating system, you should look to change the filters every couple of months. Also, any heating registers and air vents should be kept clean and clear of obstructions to the airflow. Remember, dust and lint accumulation needs to be cleaned from electric baseboard heaters immediately. We also recommend ensuring your heating and air conditioning systems are serviced annually. This will make a difference in efficiency and will help extend the lifetime of those important systems. You'll want to be sure that pipes going to and from the water heaters are insulated properly so that the heater doesn't need to spend more energy to work harder and warm the water. So take a few hours this week to reduce the energy consumption in your home. And while you're reviewing your home, you can check out some of the other homeowner tip videos we have here. Thanks for watching, and I hope you found this useful. So first, you'll want to inspect or replace the supply hoses to your washing machine. And remember to use braided hoses for extra protection. This is extremely important as the plastic alternative can easily cause water damage to your home down the road.